Anyone want to come help push the race car inside? Not fun. What is up, guys? It's cold. It's March. I don't know why South Carolina decides needs to be 40 degrees in the morning, but it does. So, it's sunny. Birds are chirping. It's nice. It's springtime. And today we're going to fix that splitter, aka make a new one out of something that's over there. So, let's get to it. I got to pull the bumper off, and I got to take the splitter off. So this is all the gravel from New Orleans, so that's kind of cool. Some little memories from blowing up my engine, but we're going to take this off and trace it onto the new splitter material and see how we do. Here is our new splitter material. It is some fancy 10 mil Alumilite versus 5 mil Alumilite. So, theoretically, it should be good. I don't really know, but we'll find out. As you can see, this has had better days, but got through grid life, got through the hill climb. This leaning edge took a massive beating at the hill climb when we were too low and just road stuff. I mean, kept grinding down this bolt here, so that's pretty cool. Almost pulled this this stanchion through, so it's been good. It's time for better things. So, I'm gonna go ahead and put this on a new one, see what we can do. Also, the new splitter is gonna be white. I don't know how I feel about that yet. I don't know if I should try to paint it or if I should just leave it white. Maybe vinyl wrap it. I don't really know. It just kind of depends on the new livery. Right here. Just look. I'm buying skid blocks next time. That used to be a bolt. Hey, look at that. Shit is wild. Let's see if this one will come out. Yeah, it will. We're gonna be getting some new stanchions too, because I'm not a big fan of these. Not a big fan at all. Throw those on the ground, let's throw our splitter up there, and figure out how we're gonna do. Something over here has been leaking some oil. It's kind of gross. Let's
sand from the track. Yeah, we're gonna do a bit better. I also messed up cutting this one, so we're gonna cut this better too. But you know, you gotta start somewhere. You gotta start somewhere. What I'm thinking about thinking about some end plates, some splitter end plates, but I don't know if I wanna do that or not. I'm not sure. Not sure how much of that you guys saw, but we got a cutout, we got our holes drilled. I'm just gonna pull this film off, and then I gotta go run to Lowe's, get some nuts and lock washers, and we can bolt the frame onto the new splitter. And we can put it on the car, and then I'll have to figure out like stanchions and stuff. Just a quick run to the hardware store, and boom, new splitter. So I think I'm missing six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. I'm technically missing 6 bolts, but you know, it's fine. It's fine. So here's our old Johnny. Here's our new Johnny. That one held up way better than expected, so that's pretty cool to see and do. So I'm gonna try to put this on the car by myself. Probably won't work, probably I'll need Handsome's help, but we'll see. The one thing I'd like to talk about here is the bolt choice. So I have switched to elevator bolts. So they are flat on the bottom, no heads sticking out. I used to use just normal hex bolts, then I went to button head Allen bolts, and now for this iteration we're just gonna use elevator boys. So nice and smooth on the bottom. Pretty stoked about how this is coming out. Hopefully this works and I can quit making splitters, because it gets old pretty fast. So I'm gonna try to throw this on the car, see how we look, and see how we go from there. Don't have my sunglasses, so it's bright. Oh, but we have the splitter kind of installed. There is about 2.5 inches of ground clearance between the road and the splitter, so that's gonna see some impact at some point. The one thing I still gotta figure out is how to do my stanchions, because I'm just like really done using these guys. Not a big fan of them. I think I might switch to professional awesome stuff. I like theirs, so I just gotta see what I can find, and we'll give that a shot. But that's what I'm thinking we're gonna do. So right now we're gonna cut my bumper some more, because I gotta do some different ducting, so we're gonna get to cutting. Putting a mask and respirator. Well, this is dead, so
for this project.
All right, so we have our splitter loosely on. I just cut off a part of my bumper because I needed some room to improve my ducting a little bit. We need to make basically a hole that is a third of the surface area as my, what do you call it? As my core of the radiator. So we're gonna try to figure out how to do that. That was in the way, it was blocking a lot of airflow to the top side of this duct. It's kind of hanging down to like here, so just chop that out. So now we have some more room. Honestly, this might be a good enough hole, which would be pretty rad if it was. If not, we'll get creative with some tape and kind of tape it off. These guys are going. I got to figure out a better way to mount this splitter. So, not totally sure how we're going to do that yet. Maybe some cables, maybe some professional awesome mounts. I don't know. We'll figure it out. So, loosely the splitter's on and we're slowly getting ready for grid life. Where are we going? All right, we're going to the National Corvette Museum in Bowling Green, Kentucky. So we're getting closer. Miles has to finish up the engine. Hopefully he gets the engine done in time. And while we wait, we improve. So we're using our time well and not wasting time here. So that's kind of the plan. But yeah, that's I'd say that's about it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. Let me know what you think of the new splitter. Let me know how you think the old splitter kind of survived. I think it did pretty well, but seen better days. So again, thank you guys for watching. Thank you for the support. Also, I want to take the time to talk about the Tobu Garage James Wood Racing shirts. I'm not wearing mine because I'm cutting fiberglass and doing disgusting stuff, and I actually enjoy that shirt, so I'm not gonna ruin it. But I'll throw a link in the description. Please, you guys, head over, go hit them up, go pick up a shirt. Part of the money comes to help me fund the race car and do the cool things that I do. The other bit goes to help them just profit, and they're just some good guys out of Raleigh, North Carolina, just making shirts and liking cars. So they've got a dope little FC, and I think they have a Skyline and some other cool cars. So go over, give them follow, give them some love, buy a shirt, tag me in it, tag them in it. What's up, guys? So we've had some more splitter updates. We're gonna change some things now. The camera died earlier, so I just continued working. But the splitter is on the car, the bumper's on the car, our rods are on the car. So it's kind of hard to tell, but that gap used to be about an inch and a half because the splitter would hit down on this bumper. So how the FC2000 bumper went, kind of went up and then it pitched down, and the corner was hitting the splitter, or went up and pitched down. The corner was hitting the splitter here and basically pushed this up and then pushed the front down more because we couldn't bring it up anymore. So I had to take my trusty Dremel. You'll probably see there, maybe. You can kind of see that. So I took my trusty Dremel and hacked out like the little corner down here on both sides. That allowed me to pull the splitter up another inch or so. So now we got room. See? Fit a whole foot under there, so that's pretty dope. So by hacking up both corners, we were able to pull the splitter up by a good margin. There's some math there. I don't know the math, but now this is sealed off, which is nice. I'll still probably add maybe a little air dam here just to make it look better, but that's good. We've got our Pro Awesome splitter rods. Love these things. They detach super easily, and we'll show you that now because we're gonna change out these square clevises to some fancy boy clevises, which are right here. So I'll open this up, take these off, show them to you, and we'll get started. So the rad thing about these splitter rods, pull this little cotter pin, tap that bad boy out, rod's free. So I'm gonna pull this guy off. There you go. So now we have these little fancy boys. They say professional awesome, which is pretty dope. They're aluminum They're nice. So here's a little side by side. I think these are steel. These are kind of heavy. But we have aluminum versus steel, square versus big circle boy. So we'll put our professional awesome ones in. Just like that. Pretty simple. Still got to put it in. But ignore this bumper cutting. That was a challenge. That did not go well. So we're going to put some tape over that. But these are rad. Really like them. I got four. We'll do these two, and then we might do the rods today. All right. So we got our little professional awesome fancy boy clevises on. We'll keep the steel ones as like spares in case we ever need them. Then we've got our two more for the sides. I'm thinking we'll run probably them here would be nice, or maybe out this way a little bit. So that's kind of the current plan. But now for the moment of truth, because I've been wanting to do this for years. Let me tell you, years. We've been making splitters for a long time, and this is kind of important in making splitters, I think. All right, so it's time for the moment of truth, where I'm going to stand my fat ass on that 10 mil piece of aluminum and plastic. Now, if I did this right, we're going to be able to stand on it. If I did it wrong, you're going to see me waste like $300. So it'll be entertaining either way. But yeah, let's get to it. All right, moment of truth here, boys. We're on a fucking splitter. So I've been wanting to do this for years. I don't know how long I've been building splitters, but it's been a long time and it's come a long way. Always wanted to stand on one. I am 230 pounds right now, so that's pretty rad. Standing on splitters is like more of a flex than anything. I mean, it shows it's strong and it's good, but also when you're at speed, you'll have a distributed load. You won't just have weight between those two stanchions. So the distributed load will help, but you know, it just feels really good being able to stand on a splitter that I made. And the even cooler part is it's 10 millimeters and it's aluminum sheet and plastic, which I think is probably the coolest part. So yeah, I think this is a good spot to end on this video. So thumbs up to the splitter. I can stand on it. Makes me feel really good. And I should probably start losing some weight, but you know, it is what it is. And yeah, that's about it. So let me know your guys' thoughts and opinions. Let me know if you're impressed about the splitter. I'm super impressed and really stoked. And yeah, that's about it for this video, and we will catch y'all later. Bye y'all. Peace.